Citizen. The strength of a nation lies in the character of its citizens. A good citizen is one who behaves as if there were no laws. If a man be gracious and courteous to strangers, it shows he is citizen of the world. The first requisite of a good citizen is, in this republic of ours, is that he shall be able and willing to pull his weight. The prosperity of a country depends not on the abundance of its revenues, nor on the strength of its fortifications, nor on the beauty of its public buildings, but it consists in the number of its cultivated citizens, in its men of education, enlightenment, and character. Here are to be found its true interest, its chief strength, its real power. Civilization. Civilization is order and freedom, promoting cultural activity. Civilization begins with order, grows with liberty, and dies with chaos. The true test of civilization is not the census nor the size of cities, not the crops, no, but the kind of man the country turns out, see, the citizens, see. A sufficient measure of civilization is the influence of good women. The most necessary task of civilization is to teach man how to think. To rebuild our civilization, we must first rebuild ourselves according to the pattern laid down by life. Choose God. Choose Jesus Christ. My faith tells me that the Creator did not intend man to evolve through the ages to this stage of civilization, only now to devise something that would destroy life on this earth. See? Choose God, choose Jesus Christ. I do not believe the greatest threat to our future is from bombs or guided missiles. I don't think our civilization will die that way. I think it will die when we no longer care, when the spiritual forces that make us wish to be right and noble die in the hearts of men. Clever. Cleverness is not wisdom. One does not gain much by mere cleverness. Never desire to appear clever and make a show of your talents before men. Be honest, loving, kindly, and sympathetic to all you say and do. Cleverness will flow from you naturally if you have it. And applause will come to you unsought from those who know what to applaud. But the applause of fools is to be shunned. The height of cleverness is to conceal one's cleverness. Nothing is clever which depends upon crookedness for its success. It's clever, but is it art? He who would be too clever makes a fool of himself. He who would be too clever makes a fool of himself. Climb. Live your life each day as you would climb a mountain. An occasional glance toward the summit keeps the goal in mind, but many beautiful scenes are to be observed from each new vantage point. Climb slowly, steadily, enjoying each passing moment. And the view from the summit will serve as a fitting climax for the journey. You must climb high in order to see far. He who would climb the ladder must begin at the bottom. He that never climbed, never failed. The most difficult part of climbing the ladder is getting through the crowd at the bottom. One can get ulcers by climbing mountains that are molehills. To climb steep hills requires slow pace at first. The higher one is able to climb, the more room he finds, and the greater is the opportunity for rapid advancement. Climb high, climb far, your goal, the sky, your aim, the star. The most successful businessman is the man who holds on to the old just as long as it is good and grabs the new just as soon as it is better. No man can climb out beyond the limitations of his own character. Clothes. Dress does not make a man, but it often makes a successful one. You are never fully dressed unless you wear a smile. The fashion wears out more apparel than the man. Clothes don't make the man, but good clothes have gotten many a man a good job. 9 tailors cannot make a man. Good clothes open all doors. Keeping your clothes well pressed will keep you from looking hard pressed. Eat to please yourself. Dress to please others. The clothes don't make the man, but they make a lot of people think there is a man in them. Always dress neatly, taking care to have good materials. It is astounding how much people judge by dress. College. A true university these days is a collection of great books. You can lead a boy to college, but you cannot make him think. If a young man has a college education, so much the better are his chances for success. Only he must use them, not wear it as an ornament. What school, college, or lectures bring to men depends on what men bring to carry it home in. What school, college, or lectures bring to men depends on what men bring to carry it home in. A college education never hurt anyone who was willing to learn something afterwards. The thing taught in college and schools are not an education, but the means of education. There is nothing to be learned from professors which is not to be met in books. Colleges and universities don't educate the student. The student educates himself. All we do is set up the educational environment. The distinct characteristic of the college man should be that he is capable of intense, rapid, sustained thought. Command. The man who commands efficiency must have obeyed others in the past, and the man who obeys dutifully is worthy of being someday a commander. It is possible to give commands in such a manner as to inspire an intense desire to obey. Keep cool and you command everybody. Learn to obey and you will know how to command. Drill is good. Discipline both in mind and body. And a bad soldier will never make a good general. Gentle compulsion. An iron hand in a velvet glove. There's a great force hidden in a sweet command. He that will not command his thoughts will soon lose the command of his actions. Those who can command themselves can commend others.